So here inside the Grand Palais, which is home to the AI Action Summit this year in Paris, there are representatives, leaders of government and industry from about 80 different countries, but there are also 50 different organizations who are all being spotlighted here that are creating projects around AI for good, AI applications for climate change, for education, even cultural projects. We wanted to show you a few of them that Paris Peace Forum has selected out of 700 applicants from more than 100 countries worldwide.
I'm Talea Lupin, and I'm the portfolio manager for UN Global Pulse, which is the UN Secretary General's Innovation Lab.
So tell me a little bit about Disha and how exactly it works.
Disha is an AI initiative that we are running at the UN, and it's all about using AI for quicker and more precise disaster response.
And what kinds of disasters are you, how exactly does it work?
So imagine there is a flood or an earthquake where there is damage to buildings, and the model that we are using is comparing a before and after picture of satellite imagery and can tell us quite accurately where a lot of buildings have been damaged or have collapsed, so that we can send any kind of humanitarian aid, be it shelter or food or medical attention, to the right places.
My name is Rita Costa, and I'm with Build Up. We're a nonprofit organization working on peace building and conflict transformation in the digital era.
It's interesting because social media is viewed as an instigator of hate and certainly polarization right now, but you're using social media to peace build. How exactly are you doing that?
Basically, what we're presenting here is Phoenix, a tool that we have developed together with Data Value People and Build Up, which what it basically allows is for peace builders and mediators to conduct ethical and participatory social media listening, monitoring, analysis to inform their interventions. If you're interested in understanding anti-immigration or racist discourse and how it's polarizing online, with Phoenix, you could gather data from like media outlets, influencers, journalists, bloggers, whoever you will, whoever you're interested in understanding, gather, scrape data from public accounts and understand kind of what's going on.
My name is Professor Jerry John Kponyo from the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, representing the Responsible Artificial Intelligence Lab. So in the Care for Rare project, we are leveraging on AI to be able to identify rare diseases among newborn children. We recognize that several instances, children are born and doctors are not very sure what their conditions are, and before you could say Jack, the children are dead. So what we have done is to gather data sets to try to understand the genetic situation as far as these children are concerned, so that if there should happen that there is someone in the family with such a condition, we are able to preempt it so that we prevent such occurrences from happening.
You're literally saving lives. How do you train the medical professionals to know how to use these tools though?
So what we are doing is participatory design. So right from the word go, we bring them on board with reference to what we are doing and then pick their ideas on board so that when it comes to its implementation, it's plug and play. We try as much as possible to ensure that they don't need coding knowledge to be able to use it. We try to make it as simple as possible so that right from the word go, they are with us and its implementation and uptake is also easy.
So I'm Tajuddin and I'm with Masakani.
Tell me a little bit about what Masakani is doing.
Okay, so over the last 6 years, when Masakani started, it's about building NLP, which is the language technology tools for African languages by Africans. So it's more of people that speak their own languages that are interested in having the representation of their languages on the digital space that came together to start the organization, and that is how the community evolved from there.
And what is the most practical application of this tool then? How would you expect people to use it?
So a lot of ways. So literacy rate varies across different countries in Africa. And what that means is that you can have, say, farmers that do not understand, say, English or French or the colonial languages, except their own languages, which means now This tool will enable them, if we are able to use AI properly, it will enable them to have better decisions in how they do their agriculture. And what that means is more income for them, and what that brings is more development for the overall development of the society and community.